So I'm Michail from the Faculty of Medicine from Yuval Shaked, the research group, which, thank you very much, which and our research focuses on cancer. And today I will speak about the novel way to treat cancer. But let's first answer a very basic question. What is cancer? As I want to present you in this short animation, cancer is a disease that starts from a single cell somewhere in our body. The cell gains mutations, as you will see it now, and then it starts to proliferate, to divide in the uncontrolled manner. This may cause in different organs and in different tissues, and when the tumor grows, different cells can detach from this primary tumor and go to the bloodstream and go to the distant sites in our body to create metastasis. This mainly happens in brain, in lungs, or in liver. The good point is in all this story is that we now actually have quite good therapies to treat cancer, like chemotherapy, radiotherapy, immunotherapy, or biological treatments, and we can prolong the life of cancer patients. If we zoom inside the tumor, we can find a whole milieu of different kinds of cells that populate the tumor. I hope you can see that the blue cells here in this picture are the cancer cells. But all the other colorful cells, the red, greens, and others, are different cells that come from outside the tumor. And they are immune cells, they are fibroblasts which create the matrix of the tissue of the tumor, they are endothelial cells which create and build blood vessels, and all together they support tumor growth. If we now focus only on the cancer cells, on the blue cells, then here also we have different subtypes of cells. But there is only one gold cell, which are the initiators, which are stem cells, cancer stem cells, like stem cells in all other tissues in our body. And these cells are the only ones who know to initiate tumor growth. They also are responsible for metastatic process. Now, these cells there are some evidences that these cells are also very resistant to chemotherapy. And I want here to thank the previous speaker for the great introduction in this area. So their resistance may partially explain why current therapies are not always effective. Why the chemotherapy, for example, kills the green, normal, regular cells, cancer cells, but the nasty, gray cancer stem cells survive the treatment. And after some period of time, these cells divide again and rebuild a tumor, and then we have the relapse of the disease. Therefore, a new kind of treatment, a novel kind of treatment is needed, which will combine the regular therapy together with the anti-cancer stem cell therapy. And then these gray cancer stem cells will be damaged, and the chemotherapy will kill the green cancer cells, and altogether it will lead to the tumor shrinkage, and we're able to cure the disease. As you already know, different types of cells enter the tumor. So one of these cells are mesenchymal stem cells. Actually, these cells are quite abundant in our body. They're responsible for creating and forming different organs, like bones by transforming into osteoblasts, like fat that protect us and warm us, and cartilage, which protects our bones. So these cells are in different places in our body, and they also come into the tumors. And it is well known that mesenchymal stem cells are also very resistant to chemotherapy, and they promote resistance. So in our lab, we're actually looking for a link for the language between these cells, which may explain why some tumors are resistant. And to answer this question, we went to pancreatic tumors. And again, Benny presented very good that pancreatic tumors are actually, we don't know how to treat them well. So we took these pancreatic tumors, and this is the untreated state when the tumors are not treated. And you can see here in red, I hope you can see it, in red the cancer stem cells. And in green are the mesenchymal stem cells. And they're located inside the tumor. But what happens when we treat these tumors? Actually, now the chemotherapy kills most of the cancer cells, or part of them, but the number of cancer stem cells now grows because they are resistant to chemotherapy. Also, another interesting fact is that green mesenchymal stem cells that come outside from the tumor, they actually now incorporate in the clusters of cancer stem cells. And this may suggest that there is a very close, very intimate dialogue between the two types of cells. So we want to understand the language between the mesenchymal stem cells and the cancer stem cells, and to find the mediators, the words between these two types of cells. For this purpose, we did some arrays and assays, and we found various factors that may be these words in the dialogue between these two cells, but the most potent factor was CXCL10, a small molecule, a small peptide, which is highly elevated by secretion by the mesenchymal stem cells. So in this point, we wanted to know how this CXCL10 affects cancer stem cells. And what we did, we put CXCL10, this peptide, on the cancer cells, on the yellow cells. And what we saw after several days, that there is a strong effect on the cancer stem cells, and there were much more cancer stem cells in our place. There were tumor spheres which are very rich with cancer stem cells. So we now understand that mesenchymal stem cells secrete secrete some factors which induce and protect and support cancer stem cells. As I showed you before, the treatment with chemotherapy induced the intimate crosstalk, the dialogue between the two types of cells. So we thought, why not to use these green mesenchymal stem cells that come from outside the tumor and to use them as Trojan horses, to use them to kill the red cancer stem cells. And then we'll be able to reduce the resistance to chemotherapy, and the treatments will be more efficient. So let's take another analogy. Okay, that's maybe what I want the most now, and maybe some of you will have it during your lunch in about half an hour. But these fries are actually like mesenchymal stem cells. We all know they're tasty, but we all know they're not healthy. Okay, and even maybe cancerogenous. They even maybe lead to cancer. But only if we use these fries, and we'll prepare these fries from different type of potato, for example, purple potato, then maybe we'll be able to treat cancer stem cells. We'll be able to cheat our body and to treat cancer stem cells, to treat cancer. So that's what we did in the collaboration with Professor Marcel Makhlouf from the Faculty of Biotechnology here in Technion. We created nanoghosts. We took mesenchymal stem cells, we emptied all the inner parts of the cells, and only the membrane remained. And then we put inside the anti-CXCL10 drug, and when these nanoghosts, when they home to the tumors, they will release this drug and will actually kill cancer stem cells. Then we'll be able to kill and to cure the tumor, the patient, sorry. So I want to show the preliminary results, and these are mice, the in vivo imaging of mice, and these colors represent colon tumors in these mice. So this is the untreated state. But what happens when we treat these mice with chemotherapy? After a treatment, we treat these mice and we wait for several weeks, and we see that there is a relapse of the disease. Actually, the tumors become bigger. You can see here the scale. The tumors become much bigger in these mice. Then what happens when we combine the treatment of chemotherapy together with the transformed mesenchymal stem cells? And what we see, that the tumors now become smaller. So our mesenchymal stem cells manage to kill cancer stem cells and to reduce tumor growth. The take-home message of all this lecture, and what I want you to remember, is that mesenchymal stem cells secrete some factor, one of them, 6 or 10, and actually protect the cancer stem cells. They induce tumor growth. But if we manage to use nanogos, to use small particles which will block the expression of 6L10, then we'll wipe the language, we'll delete the link between the mesenchymal stem cells and the cancer stem cells, and then the tumors will be smaller, we'll kill the cancer stem cells, our mice will be happier, and we hope we'll be able to cure the cancer. I want to thank the organizers again, my supervisor, Professor Val Shakid, all my lab, our collaborators, Professor Marcel Makhlouf, the ERC grant, Technion, and of course you. Thank you for listening.